Okay, so we are starting our low poly version for this weapon, and you can see I have in notepad a number of 35,000 triangles, and this is the maximum amount triangles that we can use for the weapon and the details that we have with the weapon, like grip, laser sight and our scope. The weapon alone will be something around 50,000 triangles. So you can see that I turned off these details like scope and grip and laser sight, and we will be starting low poly version for only the main weapon. We will start from this middle part of the weapon, and while making low poly version we have two ways to do this. We can create our low poly from scratch, from, let's say, simple box, and we can of course duplicate our high poly version and modify this version by cutting number of polygons down. So you can see I've chosen the second method. I've duplicated this high poly part and I'm deleting edge loops. And of course we have to clean up everything. Sometimes it's just faster to create something from scratch rather than deleting all these edge loops and creating different topology. But for example, for this part, for me it was better to use this high poly version. Of course we have to remember about smooth groups, or you will find a smooth groups in 3ds Max, but for in Maya we've got of course soft edges and hard edges. So you have to remember about creating hard edges in some places. So of course a simple stuff in place where you have a hard edge, you have to remember to split this area on your UVs, because if you will not do this, your normal map will be incorrect in this place. So you can see that we are starting from this middle part of the weapon, and we will be making next the upper part of the weapon, and our goal is to start from the biggest parts of the weapon to create a main shape without any little details like screws and switches, because we want to see how many polygons or triangles we need to create a decent shape of the weapon, a main shape. So after creating the main shape, we are able to see how much polygons are left, how much polygons we can spend on these little details like screws, for example, or switches. Okay, you can see that this part is ready. We will now move to the next part, and the next part will be this main drip. And I will show you the second method of creating low poly version, and we will make this high poly version alive. What it will do? It will allow us to create polygons on the surface of this high poly mesh. And you can see right now I'm using a relatively new tool in Maya 2015 that allows us to do something like, for example, in TopoGAN or any other software for creating mesh, for retopologizing mesh. So you can see this method allows us to create this geometry from scratch almost. But for me, of course, for this part, it will be faster to duplicate this high poly and remove few edge loops, and it will be ready. So you can see right now I'm deleting these edge loops. We will optimize the wireframe a little bit by removing some polygons and edges. So this grip part is very simple. Okay, so right after finishing this grip part, we are moving finally to this upper part of the weapon, and you can see this mesh is pretty heavy, and of course it would be very cool to just duplicate this part and remove few edge loops, but unfortunately with this part we can't do this, so I have to create this upper part of the weapon from scratch. So what we will do is just basically same stuff that we've been doing when we were creating a high poly, but this time it will be without tons of edge loops. So you can see that I keep my high poly version of the model in the background as a reference layer, and I'm following just the shape of the high poly version. So you can see our upper part is done, and now we are moving to creating this backside of the weapon, and this will be very cool because we don't have to create this mesh from scratch like the one before. We can just duplicate it and remove details and edge loops, polygons, and it will be fine. can see our back side of the weapon, it's complete. I skip this part of the weapon because it was just the same stuff as before, so just to save you a time. And right now we have also these two parts between the center part of the weapon and the back side of the weapon, and I have them selected right now, so you can see they are a little bit advanced. And I think if I remember correctly, I was creating them from this high poly. And of course we will have to do barrel and our magazine, and then we'll be ready to create these little details. And of course at the end I will show you some low poly stuff for the scope. So let's see how our barrel was done, and you can see I've also duplicated this high poly part and we've optimized it. So I've just deleted few edge loops, I've merged some vertices, and that's it. It was pretty simple. Okay, right now we've skipped a lot of material here, and we have ready our laser sight, our grip, and we will move to more interesting stuff, our scope. I've skipped these parts because, you know, it was just the same stuff. So let's focus on more interesting parts, like this scope, for example. Of course, it wasn't that good to duplicate it and optimize it. I just had to create it from scratch, and I've started with a simple cylinder, and by extruding the edges of the cylinder I was following the basic shape of the scope, and I was creating a low poly version of this scope. you can see I am using again this quad draw tool. It was very helpful here because we have tons of weird shapes, so to quickly create the low poly version of this scope I've used really a lot of this quad draw tool. So we've skipped a little bit of this process, and right now you can see how I'm using this tool to create this part. It is of course still a pretty slow process even when using this tool, but it's probably way faster and more precise than creating these shapes in traditional way. So you can see with this quad draw tool we can create polygons and also delete it. We can split them, and we can of course merge vertices. So it's pretty handy. So you can see right now the final version of our scope. Of course, this part below the red pipe was created using, of course, the quad draw tool. And that's it.